Hi, I'm Sam Tecriti, and today we'll be giving you an overview of the modular prefabrication process. Starting off with the material handling and storage section, you'll see that one of the advantages of modular building manufacturing is the controlled environment, where the building materials and equipment are stored inside the manufacturing facility and never impacted by rain, snow, or wind. This obviously enhances the quality of materials used in the modular buildings. Additionally, material handling and inventory procedures become more effective in contributing to an efficient and accelerated building process. Mobile modular buildings are typically constructed and positioned on structural steel frame that essentially serves two purposes. First is carrying the load of the building, and second is transporting the buildings. There are two types of frames: a perimeter frame, which consists of two perimeter steel I-beams and an intermediate joist or cross members. This frame is usually used for heavier buildings and where perimeter foundations are required. An outrigger frame, which is what we see here, consists of two junior I-beams with truss or solid cross members. This frame is usually used in lighter and more standardized buildings. All frame members are welded and painted with an anti-rust paint. The frames are carried by an axle system, and depending on the weight of the building, the number of axles are determined, and it could vary from 2 to 8 axles per building. Typically, an axle is rated for 6,000 pounds plus an additional safety factor. The tires usually are rated for 3,100 pounds and inflated to a cold pressure of 115 pounds. Here's where the floor section is built. The first step in the process is to install an underlayment on the steel frame to protect the building from moisture, insects, and pests. The floor section is then framed using traditional lumber. A standard floor configuration would consist of 2x6 joists at 16 inches on center. Obviously, that would vary depending on building size and projected design loads. The floor section is then placed on and bolted to the steel frame. Unfaced bat insulation with a standard R value of 19 is then placed between the joists. The insulation requirements will also vary depending on the project's energy requirements and location. Here we see the floor decking is being installed using 5/8 plywood tongue and groove decking, which is secured to the framing below with adhesive and mechanical fasteners. Following that, the floor area is sanded to ensure a smooth substrate for the finished flooring application. The vinyl floor tiles are installed in a controlled environment and allowed to cure before it moves on to the next station. The flooring from this point forward will also be protected to avoid any damage during the manufacturing process. The next step is constructing the interior and exterior walls, and for both, the process is the same. Using flat assembly cables, the walls are framed using 2x4 or 2x6 studs at 16 inches on center, with bat insulation placed in between and as needed to meet the building energy requirements. What's important to note here is the fixed tolerances allowed in the wall fabrication process as a result of using the dimensional framing table. Door and window openings are placed utilizing prefabricated components to ensure standardized measurements and efficient handling. In parallel, all electrical and plumbing roughing components are installed within the wall section prior to placing the interior drywall panels. Each wall section is marked with an identification code so it can be properly placed on the building footprint. The interior and exterior wall sections are then lifted and placed into the floor section in accordance with the building floor plan. The HVAC unit is also installed in this section prior to any of the exterior finished work commencing. One of the core advantages of modular building manufacturing process is having multiple component prefabrication stations that allow for a repetitive and thus consistent process of assembling core building components, such as walls, doors, and HVAC ductwork. This process ensures the control tolerances required during the assembly process are achieved. The roof and ceiling section is typically fabricated in one station, and depending on the type of interior ceiling used, the process may change a bit. Here we see a roof section that has a hard deck ceiling, and as a result of that, the first step in the process is to lay the ceiling drywall panels first, then place the roof trusses as per the engineering design. The trusses are mechanically fastened and or adhered to the ceiling panels. Again, little room for dimensional variations due to the fixed framing tables used to assemble the roof sections. The roof section is then lifted and placed on a secondary station where all the electrical wiring, the insulation, and the HVAC ductwork is installed in the roof cavity. Additionally, light fixtures and diffusers are installed on the finished side of the roof section. The completed roof section is then lifted and placed on the building module and fastened as per the engineering drawings. In this station, the exterior wall sheathing and the air barrier is installed. So basically, here is where the building gets enclosed and enters into the finishing stage. And on this particular building, a hardy panel siding is being installed. The siding panels are pre-cut and pre-painted in different stations and done in a controlled environment within this facility. In this station, we have a lot of components going in. Exterior doors, windows, plumbing fixtures, and interior finish. The roof membrane is also installed in the station. Again, the interior conditions of a manufacturing facility allow for a consistent temperature and environment for the placement and curing of all components. At this point, the unit will undergo a series of testing procedures to ensure the building electrical and mechanical systems are operating as required by the design specifications and building codes. From a plumbing standpoint, the water supply, drainage, ventilation, and fixtures will be tested utilizing air and water pressure tests. Electrically, all receptacle circuits will be tested for proper voltage and polarity. Light fixtures and exit signs will also be inspected and tested for operation. The HVAC unit and exhaust fans will also be inspected for installation, location, and operation. Here, the unit is in the final cleaning stage, where the building interior is cleaned, the vinyl floors are waxed and sealed, the walls, doors, and windows are wiped down. The exterior siding is also cleaned, and the building is then prepared for final inspections. Once the unit is offline, it undergoes a series of final quality inspections and sign-offs. And since the building has passed 5 quality inspection points online that address every major manufacturing stage, the final inspection focuses mainly on finishes and overall appearance. It should be noted, however, that all units are inspected by third-party state building inspectors to ensure the buildings are manufactured to the design standards and state code requirements. Thanks for joining me. I hope this was helpful in demonstrating the value and quality of the modular prefabrication process.